हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट यूनिट वन क्वांटिटेटिव एनालिसिस। सो लेट मी डिस्कस व्हाट इज क्वालिटेटिव एंड क्वांटिटेटिव एनालिसिस। क्वालिटेटिव इज नथिंग बट व्हाट हियर। सो क्वालिटेटिव इज नथिंग बट हियर वी आर गोइंग टू डू द सॉल्ट एनालिसिस, मिक्सचर एनालिसिस, व्हाट एवर इट इज। ओके, दैट वन वी कॉल इट इज क्वालिटेटिव। कमिंग टू क्वांटिटेटिव, so quantitative analysis is nothing but we also call it as typometric analysis and also volumetric analysis. Okay, so the volumetric analysis we are going to say here quantitative analysis, okay. So coming to here, this quantitative analysis is nothing but what here we are going to speak about volumetric analysis. So now let us see what is volumetric analysis. So hope you have understood what I am asking. What is volumetric analysis? So coming to here, in this chapter we are going to learn mainly the principle of volumetric analysis. So what are the types we are going to have? Means we are having acid based titrations, complex ohmmetric titrations, redox titrations, precipitation titrations. So these are the titrations we are having, and also we are having gravimetric analysis. So these are the things we are going to learn in this unit. So what is titrant, what is titrant, what is standard solution? So these are the things basing upon the practical we are going to learn in this. So now let us see here quantitative analysis. So quantitative analysis is nothing but volumetric analysis. Then what is volumetric analysis? So here the volumetric analysis is nothing but here we are going to speak mainly about the volume. In the name itself we are having, see here, volumetric is nothing but what here we are mainly going to speak about volume of two reagent solutions, which one is of known concentration and other one is of unknown concentration. So that is nothing but what here, volumetric analysis. Okay, so what we can say here, the volumetric analysis is nothing but which we are going to deal mainly with the volume of two solutions, in that one is known concentration, another one is volume of unknown concentration. Okay, so this one we call it as volumetric analysis. So now the known concentration, so let us write definition. The volume of two solutions of which one is of known concentration and the other of unknown concentration, we call it as what, volumetric analysis. So then what is known concentration, what is unknown concentration? So we are saying that here standard solution. So what is standard solutions? So when you do titrations, first of all we have to do standard solutions. Without doing standard solutions we can't do the titrations. Okay, so now coming to here, the standard solution, the known concentration we call it as standard solution. The solution whose concentration is known, means already we are going to know the concentration. In the question, for example, they have given you 0.03 molarity of hydrochloric acid present in the NaCl solution. Okay, so means what, 0.03 molarity indicates what, their concentration. So already we know the concentration of HCl. So that one we call it as whatever concentration we are knowing, that one we call it as standard solution. Okay, so how we are going to prepare this standard solution? So generally this standard solution prepared by taking a some fixed amount of primary substance and dissolving it in a known volume of solvent. Means what here? For example, how we are going to prepare the standard solution? As we know the volume, for example 1000 ml, I have taken 1000 ml of HCl. So what I know here, I know the volume. So to this volume, first what I should calculate, let us take, I'm taking here molarity, which is denoted by capital M. Okay, so molarity, what is the definition of molarity? The number of moles of solute present in liter of the solution. That one we call it as molarity, which is represented by formula weight by gram molecular weight into 1000 by V ml. Means the number of moles, number of moles formula is weight by gram molecular weight present per liter of the solution. Okay, so as we know the volume of the solution, that is 1000. Okay, that is m equals to weight by gram molecular weight into 1000 by V is also I have given 1000. So now what happens here? So as concentration, you know, so I'm taking HCl. HCl, the gram molecular weight will be always 36.5. Molarity, for example, I have given 0.1. This is the molarity. Okay, the concentration we know. So then you are going to get, you have to calculate weight, how much you have to take. Okay, so here the weight is equals to m into gram molecular weight. This 1000 will get cancelled. Then what is the molarity I have given? 0.1 into 36.5, which will be giving some 1/10 into 36.5/10. So you are going to get 3.65 grams. Okay, so this is the weight we got. So this one, this is the fixed amount of the substance. Okay, so we know the volume we know, and also we have got the weight also. So then what we are calculating? The concentration. If you know the one, so by this easily you can calculate concentration. So by this what we can get? M is equals to 3.65/36.5 into 1000/1000. So by this what we can get here? Some 0.1 molarity. So by this we can easily calculate what here? Concentration. Means first of all what we should know? The normality, molarity, molality. Without knowing these formulas, we cannot calculate the concentrations and weights also. Okay, so now what I'm saying here, how to prepare standard solution. So to prepare standard solution, we should know first of all the weight of the fixed amount of weight of the substance we should know, and also the volume of the solvent. Okay, how much? So I have taken 1000 ml of HCl. This 1000 ml of HCl is nothing but what here? In this HCl contains, and also water also contains. Means the volume indicates what here? Solvent. Solvent means what? Large amount what I have been taking, that is indicating solvent. Means I can take either solutions, means some of the solvents like benzene like that, or I can take water also. Okay, the HCl is dissolving in water, that's why I have taken here the solvent as a water. So this is the, by knowing the weight and by knowing the volume of the solvent, we can easily calculate the concentration. By this we are going to get the standard solution. If we know the concentration means only, we can calculate the standard solution. So this is the meaning of the standard solution. So as I am saying, in standard solution, the primary standard substance. So the primary standard substance is nothing but what? This one, HCl, I have been taking. So this HCl is nothing but what here? This HCl indicates some 3.61. So this is the primary standard substance. This HCl indicates what here? Primary standard substance. So what is this primary standard substance? So this primary standard substance follows some conditions. So what are those conditions? Let us see. Okay, so primary standard substance, we are saying, so in this I have taken primary standard substance as a HCl. So for this, what it should have, some conditions it should have. For this, the first condition should be, it should be in a pure form. Whatever compound we are taking, that should be in a pure form and we can easily handle. It should be easy to handle. We have whatever substance we are taking, that should we can handle easily. Okay, so it should be stable when compared to atmosphere. When it is present in the atmosphere, the salt water you are taking or the compound water taken, that should be stable. Okay, and also in case of hydrated salts, the water of crystallization should be fixed and of single composition. If you take hydrated salts, means water compounds, what we should have, you should have crystallization, means the water should form the crystallization, and also it should be fixed and single composition, and also it should have high equivalent weight. So these are the conditions we should have to the primary standard solution substance. So what is the primary, whatever known concentration you are taking, that one considers primary standard substances. Okay, the first standard substance, to get the primary standard substances, you should have some condition, that should be, it should be pure form, which should handle easily, and it should be stable when exposed to atmosphere, and also it should have high equivalent weight. Okay, so this is nothing but primary standard substances. Okay, so now general we are having acids. So this is about generally primary standard substance. Mineral acid solutions, mineral acid solutions is nothing but what here, sodium hydroxide is not considered as a primary standard. So that one we call it as mineral acid. So what is the mineral acids? So mineral acid is nothing but sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide is not considered as a primary standard substance. Why? Because if you have been observed the sodium hydroxide salt, it is like a pellets. Okay, so it is like a some round shape we are going to have. This one we call it as what here, pellets. So that's why it is not concerned. It can easily absorb the atmosphere also. The pellets, whatever you are taking outside, it will easily absorb atmosphere and it can become liquid. So because of this reason, what we can say here, it is not going to absorb the primary standard solutions. Okay, so then which type of compounds it is going to absorb the primary standard substances? Substances like KCl, AgNO3, Na2CO3, oxalic acid. So these are the substances is going to absorb the primary standard solution. Okay, so here oxalic acid is there, for example, two molecules of water is also it can come. So generally oxalic acid formula will be when you combine C2H4 C2H2O4.2H2O. So in this water molecule is there, no? So what I have told you, in these conditions, when you are having water type of compounds, it should have a water crystallization. So means what here, here we are, the oxalic acid will be in a crystalline form. So means what here, it is, the water is always fixed. So that's why it is considered as a oxalic acid primary standard compounds. Okay, so this is nothing but primary standard. So then what is secondary standard? So then what is secondary standard solutions. Second is standard, means which you are going to take it in the next one. Okay, so means what here? We can say, for example, hydroxides, KOH, NaOH, mineral acids, potassium permanganate, ammonium thiocyanate. So means what? NaOH and also potassium permanganate, KMnO4, ammonium thiocyanate, SCN twice. Okay. So, and also many salts which are there. That one we call it as secondary standard substances. So, secondary standard substances should be here standardized by titrating against a substance of primary standard substance. So, what is secondary standard here? In burette, what you are taking, that is the primary standard. And in pipette, what you are taking, that is the secondary standard. So, means what? By titrating with the primary standard compound only, now we are getting to get the secondary standard. So, this is nothing but secondary standard solution. Okay, so the standard solution usually taken in the burette. That one we call it as what here? Primary standard. So, then what? This is about a general introduction of primary and secondary. Now, coming to here, then what is titration? So, what is titration here? The standard solution which is usually taken in the burette, that one we call it as what here? The standard solution which is taken in the burette to complete the reaction, we call it as titration. The standard solution is taken in the burette. Okay, so by adding standard solution burette from the send from the burette, what we can get? And from burette we are adding solution to the conical flask to complete the chemical reaction. We call it as what here? Titration. Okay, so what is titration? We are saying the process of adding the standard solution from the burette until the chemical reaction is complete, that one we call it as what here? Titration. So then what is titrant? What is titrant? Okay, so coming to here, the titrometric analysis is used for estimation of solutions only, we are going to say. That one indicates over here, the term volumetric analysis, we call it as gas analysis also. So then what is titrant and what is titrate? So titrant is nothing but here, what here? Titrant means which have been known the concentration. The known concentration we call it a standard solution. The standard solution which is prepared, which has been already prepared, that one we call it as titrant. Okay, and the unknown concentration, that one we call it as titrate. What is titrant in this? We are having two types. The known concentration means the standard solution, we call it as what here? Titrant. So what is titrate? So what is titrate? Unknown concentration, which we don't know the unknown concentration, that one we call it as what? Titrant. Okay, so for example, let us take here, when you adding from burette one endpoint you are going to get, then by using that value you are going to calculate the concentration, right? So that one we call it as what? Titrate. Okay, so when the titrant and the titrate, when the titrant and the titrate which is reacting in a conical flask, so there will be some completion of the reaction. Okay, so when both are mixing, so we are going to get here one complete reaction, that one we call it as what here? End point. Okay, So means what the completion of reaction should clearly we can see with our eye. Yes or no? So if you get pale pink, that one we can see, no? If you get some blue color, we can see that. So means what here? The reaction, what it is complete, we can easily see with our eye. So either adding an indicator, either without adding an indicator. So here external indicator. So when you add an indicator, what here? So between these two, if you add indicator, we are going to get the here end point. So for example, if you take acid base, NaCl, NaOHn, HCl. For that, you are going to add methyl orange indicator. Example, if you take here in the titration of HCl and NaOH, you are going to use indicator what here? Methyl orange. So what is the color we are going to get? Pale pink. So this is the end point we are taking. So means what here? What is the extra we are adding here? Methyl orange indicator. Okay. So which will give you, when you are adding to the titrant, then automatically what happened, there will be color change, which is equivalent point. For example, we have seen here self indicator. So this is nothing but external indicator. Then self indicator is nothing but what here? Self indicator means the self indicator is nothing but here, which is one of the reactant that is on the, which will complete the reaction. For example, if you take potassium permanganate, okay, and oxalic acid. Okay, so when you take this reaction here, the potassium permanganate will act as a self indicator to get the end point. So this is nothing but self indicator. Here we are adding, but here we are not adding any indicator. In these reactions we are getting here pale pink, which is an end point. So in this we are not adding any indicator. That's why the KMnO4 itself is acting as a self indicator. Why? Because it is a redox reaction, it will undergo both oxidation and also reduction. Okay, so this is the brief introduction of the volumetric analysis. In this we are going to have four types volumetric analysis. The classification, one is neutralization or acid bed titrations. The first one is acid bed titration or neutralization titration. So means what here? For example, if you have been taken HCl plus NaOH, this is the acid, this is the base, you are going to get NaCl plus H2O. Okay, so this H2O will be a neutral compound. H plus plus OH minus, acid and base, it will give H2O. Okay, so this one we call it as acid base titrations. And next one we are having redox titrations. So this redox titration is nothing but both oxidation and reduction. This one we call it as redox titration. Combination of oxidation reduction we call it as oxidometry titrations. So here if you take in some 10FeSO4, 2KMnO4 plus 8H2SO4, potassium permanganate and also more salt. So it is going to give K2SO4, MnSO4, Fe2SO4 thrice, 8H2. Okay, so this is redox titration. Why? Because here we are not going to add any indicators. Here we are adding here methyl orange indicator. So this is one of the titration. Next one we are having precipitation titrations. So this precipitation titration is also known as argentometry. Argentometric titration. Why? Because here if you take Az plus Cl minus, it will give AgCl. So when you add some of the compounds in the titrations, there will be formation of precipitation. That's why we call it a precipitation titrations. Okay, so this silver we call it as argentometry also. Argentinium, no, Ag is the symbol of silver. So this one is the argentinium. So this is also known as argentometric titrations. So next one we are having complexometric titrations. What is next one we are having? Complexometric titration. So it is going during the titration, it will form some complexes, like when you react with AgNO3 plus 2KCN, then here it is going to form KAgCN twice plus KNO3. So means what here? It is a complex. So metal ligand complexes, as we have seen in the coordination compounds, right? Like that it is going to form. So there is a ligand and also metal. So this is a complexometric titrations. So this is nothing but what here? Different types of titrations. These four only we are going to discuss each by one. And with suitable indicators, the volumetric analysis also can have some instrumental techniques like potentiometric titrations, based upon the pH values, and conductometric titrations, amphometric titrations, pH metric titrations, spectrophotometric titrations. So basing these all about instrumental techniques. By instrumentation we can easily find these titrations also. So this is nothing but general detection and classification. So these four we are going to learn in the next class, each one by one. And we are having grammetric analysis also after completion of this, we can see. Thank you.